Spirit will break through the barriers. They will cut through just like we would cut through glass. The Lord says, my hand will sever the enemy's head.
Yes.
I feel like there's a release of another word, prophetic word. The prophet is going to speak right now, but I don't know what's coming.
There's an authority
coming in your voice, says the Lord. An authority upon your tongue, says the Lord. Even tonight I lay it upon you heavily, says the Lord, and with your mouth you will move mountains. With your mouth you shall speak, says the Lord. Even the revelation, even the living word, which is God Himself. Upon your tongue you shall speak. And even this very night, your authority in the heavenly, says the Lord, I increase by my spirit, by my spirit, by my spirit. Tonight, in Jesus' name. Jesus. Let's just see how this works. I'm going like this. I can hardly stand here. I don't know what I'm going to do and where I'm going to...
Just stretch your hands out. Let's pray over Prophet Jacques. I just felt like when we were praying in the pastor's lounge, I felt like God says that the rivers that are flowing through you are going to be completely new.
Yes.
And they will be nourished. They will be nourished. They will be replenished. It will be like Psalm 1. Everything planted next to that river will grow. It will grow and it will flourish. It will flourish. There are many pastors that have toiled for many years, for a long time, even in our community. And they have seen naught. They have seen the ministry come to naught because of people that remain unfaithful and wavering. This word wavering that keeps coming up. But the Lord knows the faithful. The Lord knows those that would stay, those that would pray, those that would come into the kingdom and stand with the purpose and destiny to which they are called and the house to which they are called. And the Lord is so busy with you, prophet, right now, Lord. Just loose his tongue. God's going to give you a tender heart as you speak tonight. Even though you will carry a boldness, there is a tender shoot that is sprouting and budding in your heart even now.
Yes.
Lord, I pray that we would receive this word. The Lord says that we must welcome the prophets. Do not. The house must have prophets. The foundation is apostles and prophets. And we release that right now, that the word would be heard and received. We can't just hear, we have to receive. Amen. Jesus, thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Nobody was more powerful than the Lord Jesus on earth. Amen. Yet, he wept for the people. Why? Because he saw how Satan had attacked, killed, and destroyed the people. I just want to say this to you quickly. If you are a prophetic person, you manifest what is going on in the spirit. What is going on in the spirit realm, you manifest it. It's not something I choose. Try and understand that. I'm not trying to be Mr. I'm zero up here. Jesus must be everything. But I am manifesting as I stand here what is going on in the spirit. It is manifesting in me. You understand that?
Yes.
So please do not reject me because I am manifesting something. Take what God wants to do. Amen? I don't want you to sit down here, please. I want the oats with the horns up here as well. The whole theme is, let your will be done, let your kingdom come. Amen?
Yes.
Does that sound to you like a picnic? Does it sound to you like war?
Yes.
I want to tell you, and we've been saying this for a while, we are at war. Who here is blood washed, born again?
Yes.
I want to ask you something, please. I beg you, not go on my knees if I have to. You hear now. Many of us have come a far way, but you hear now. Forget your watch just for a moment and begin to think kingdom. Try and figure what can happen if a bunch of believers unite together. What can be established?
and loosed and released in the spiritual realm. And that's what I had in my spirit weeks back at home already. There was an anger and an aggression in my spirit, not towards the redeemed, but towards the enemy that has robbed and killed and destroyed our people for too long. And if I am manifesting it, it is because God is manifesting it thus tonight. You say, can God get like this? Can God get angry? Yes. Psalms 47. You all know, oh clap your hands, all you people, shout to God with a voice of triumph. But verse 5 says, God has gone up with a shout. God has gone up with a shout. The Lord with a sound of trumpets. Can we count to three? I know everybody goes to three. We can do four if you want. Can we go count to three and let heaven just break loose in this place? Scream and shout at the top of your lungs, please. Can we do it? Are you ready? Come on. One, two, three, and shout!
Leaders,
I join with you. Two, three, Can you feel it? Oh, this is angelic activity. On assignment, bam, yeah. Move, yes. For my redeemed, yes. My people.
Yes, yes.
Thank you. Oh, says the Lord, I am shaking. Yes, you've heard it before. I am shaking, says the Lord, the world. From every corner, says the Lord, I have my grip, yeah. And I am shaking. Yes. What can be shaken? So that what cannot be shaken, yes. Will remain.
Yes.
Says the Lord.
Amen.
The old has gone.
Yes.
Says the Lord, all the promises of old and the promises of the new have culminated. Am I not the Lord? And the Lord says, even now, that remnant church of mine, this remnant church of mine, this remnant church of mine is marching, is marching. If you are spiritual, and you all are, did you feel that in the spirit? I preached here the last time, in I think September last year, I preached on, do you hear the call? I have not felt the power like this before. Far greater than 2008. It's not my doing. Many of you face challenges. I know what that feels like. We are one. We are brothers and sisters. Amen. So merciful is God that He set this thing up using these precious people. Because God wants to retaliate. Don't mess with God. You say God is merciful and kind, wonderful He is. Don't mess with God's people. Touch not my anointed. We are precious to the Lord, amen. I want to ask you quickly, is there faith in the house tonight? Gloria says, I have bone shattering, earth moving, mountain shifting faith. There's the 10 million in the bank. There's the will. It's legal. Your name's on it. If somebody tried to prevent you getting your 10 million, what would you do? What? So I said, so why aren't we fighting what is legally ours? Yes. Is God in the business of souls?
Yes.
The Bible says, it's not God's will that one should perish. Tick that box for souls. Is it God's will for us to be poor?
No.
Does the Bible say that there's many scriptures that Jesus became poor so that we might be rich? Tick that box. Does God want us to be diseased?
No.
The temple of the Holy Spirit diseased and sick constantly?
No.
By whose stripes?
Jesus.
How dare he, the devil, touch God's redeemed. Amen. How dare that happen? I don't know about you, but I'm up to here. I just had it. There's been a dryness, yes? Amongst the unit churches. LGBI, GLBTI, yes? There's been a dryness. I will prove it to you, yes? Guys, tonight just focus. Just focus on this guy, please. But he loved me as any manara. Just check. Just do the end. Just stick it out. Amen. Please, I beg you. I want to ask you this.
You don't have to
beg
us, prophet.
I want to ask you this.
Yes,
answer me. I want you to put your hand up. This is an interactive tonight, not just me. We are a body that says, we've had enough. I'll ask you this. How many of these churches, including all of us, have abundance of finances?
None.
I don't see any hands. Do you know what that does to me? It makes me mad. It should be making you very angry. We are not God's number B.
Yes.
We're not the tail of God's plan. The same blood washed me that washed anybody else.
Yes.
How many of you can say that your church is completely disease free? Everybody just hunky dory. Spiritually, mentally, subconsciously, emotionally. For too long, the enemy and demon forces have blocked our supply lines.
Yeah.
Our provision, our inheritance, our harvest.
Yes.
And it's not, I'm not yet united because I'm mad, because I am going through a tough time. Many of you are too.
Yes.
Not alone.
Yes.
Now, I'm going to ask you, before I go on, can we unite tonight in heaven? Piercing. Heaven rending faith and break strongholds.
Yes.
What is a stronghold? A stronghold is a lie that comes and sits in your mind. If you live in a town of 10,000 people, and one person gets in there that's all messed up, there's not a stronghold in the town yet. There's one person with a stronghold. But if that stronghold begins to spread, the whole place will be infected. Then that whole town, that whole region will attract demon forces, strong men, and high places will go up. And then that place will be in the stronghold.
Yep.
Jointly. Would you say that our people have some strongholds?
Yes.
Do we have the power to do something about it?
Yes.
Where two or three are gathered in my name, there am I in their midst.
Amen.
Where two or three unite together, agree, harmonize together, what happens? You will have what you ask for now. I went through this at home. I saw this. I heard that word you gave me tonight before in a dream. When you spoke it, I saw myself standing there and you there and you here. I had this in a dream a while back. Can we by force take what legally belongs to us?
Yes.
Take it by force.
Yes.
You've heard it, take it by force. That Jesus gave his life all for us to have our inheritance. Can we tonight unite? I'm telling you, if we can be tonight in unity and I sense there is unity, such power can be released. And there's no distance in the spirit.
Yeah.
What happens here will affect better run.
Yes.
My God. Yes. Often, do you listen to me, my friend? God is working in your life. But you too, I've seen something different. I met you years ago. There's a different, it does a deep dip in you. God's going to do such a spirit wrenching work in you, Pastor Lou. I think I've, at Canemdo, but I saw you again now, raised in stature. And I saw you standing in front of thousands of people with the evangelical anointing working. I saw you on the stage like this, but I love you, dear. I saw you walking, but you were tied to a whole bunch of skeletons. It looked sure.
Yeah.
And there was a whole bunch of dry bones and skeletons. Tonight, cut it off and be loose and free of that.
Thank you,
so you might run. Something new thoughts, newness, a new thing that the Lord is doing in you. You've heard that before. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Is God good or what?
Amen.
Tonight I'm talking under the heading, the kingdom of the risen King of Kings.
Yes.
Where is Christ tonight? Tonight I say to you, Christ stands established as the risen Christ.
Amen.
Now, tonight, over all of us, and if my eyes look crazy, don't worry. I'm just amped, as they say, then. That's amped. Christ stands risen now. We've heard this before. When is faith due? my ship will come in. It will never come in. Why? It has already come in. On the wings of the risen Yeshua.
Yes.
We see and master now.
Yeah.
Yeah. As you hear that sound, now, now is faith. Now, now is faith. Now, now is faith. Now is faith. Now is faith. Now is faith.
Complete the job.
As ek op jou spoeg nie waar nie, sorry hoor. Day and night, and they, who's they, the blood washed, the redeemed church, have overcome, conquered him by means of how? The blood of the Lamb and the utterance of their testimony. Testimony, we need to speak the word of God. Why? Because the word of God is not just a sound, it is life. It's God himself. It's God, our heavenly parent. The word is God. The God is both. You cannot divide the two, separate the two. For they did not love and cling to life even when faced with death. This sounds to me like a radical remnant church. I want to be part of that church. Amen.
Amen.
Revelations quickly, chapter 19, 11 to 13. Thank you, my Lord, great King of Kings, for your reign and rule. Now I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse. And he who sat on him was called faithful and true, and in righteousness he judges and makes war. How can it be so difficult for people to say, to see Jesus as making war? Jesus, don't be fooled, my friend. The Lord Jesus makes war. He's the captain of the legions. His eyes were like flames of fire, and on his head were many crowns representing unlimited diadems, which are crowns of sovereign authority. He had a name written that no one knew except himself. He was clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. Yes. And he had on his robe and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings. Yes. We heard last night, King of Kings. King of Kings. Revelations 5:10, just quickly, amplified. I'm just reading scriptures. Amplify. Let the word speak. Amen.
Amen.
And you who Jesus, you Jesus have made them. Who's them? Us, the blood washed, the redeemed, a kingdom, a royal race of priests to our God. And they shall reign as kings over the earth. Most mislead or strong man demon can appear right here now. And the smallest, youngest of you that knows who you are can chase that demon. We don't fear. They fear us. And what's inside of us? John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, or is God. You know, I have been praying over this for quite some time. When God speaks a word, as I said, it's not just a sound. It is the essence of God being released. Then the Bible says, the word of God cannot return to God void, unanswered, undone, void. Fruitless. It has to fulfill that for which it was sent.
Amen.
Yes.
And
yes, it has to. Yes.
You say I have received many words over years. I've got a whole box full. Ek is nou amper
60.
And I have got so many prophetic words. And you know what? If the Bible is true, that they cannot return to God for it, at the swallow nog steeds, I would. I am spooking and spitting and indulging. Amen to that. That word is still alive today. God said to me, you shall be a very prosperous man, and you shall have a very great ministry. Do I have now? No. That does not determine my future.
Amen.
God said to me, you shall stand before the
has said so, I shall.
Yes.
So people can come and go as they wish. The word of God cannot return void.
Yeah.
Every promise that you have received cannot return void.
Yes. Yes.
I kind of feel like six months for you. He knows. Tonight, we just stay with me. We are going to pray for every single one of you.
Amen.
En masse. En masse.
Yes.
For jobs.
Yes.
Cars.
Yes.
Houses.
Yes.
Buildings.
Yes.
Release.
Yes.
There's a scripture. Amen. Concerning life and godliness.
Amen.
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 Priests and kings, and they shall reign. Say, I shall reign.
I shall reign.
Now I reign.
Now I reign.
And the Bible says, the word is spirit and life. The devil has tried to stop this conference. God intervened.
Yes.
Yes.
God intervened.
Yes.
If not so, this conference would not have been this weekend.
Yep.
Very well might have been postponed.
Yep.
God intervened.
Yes.
God does that.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Matthew 6:19, quickly. I don't even know what's the time. I will give you. Say, give me.
Give me
the keys of the kingdom.
The keys of the kingdom.
What do keys do?
Open doors.
They open and they lock. This is a stunning scripture. This is an incredible scripture. It can drive your brain nuts. Jesus himself says, I will give you the keys of
the kingdom.
The square. Pathways, pipes of supply, blessings. speak it unblocked. We decree it unblocked. We prophesy you are unblocked.
Yes.
Be open. Amen. Be open, I say, in Jesus' name.
Yes.
And let the blessings flow.
Yes.
The provisions flow.
Thank you, Lord.
Pastor Debs.
Thank you, Lord.
Apostle, I sent you a message. A text message. I was praying for you and I got really just... And I saw you with a sword. And I send you a message. I believe that God has grace and power for you in the area of wealth. In the area of wealth. Now she knows very well what it means. It's a dominion in the area of supply. And I saw you lift your sword apostolically with the word and use it in authority to unlock and release wealth for the human people. Not only for this church, but for our people.
Yes.
And tonight, we are going to do that.
Yeah.
What you declared or decree, improper and unlawful, on earth, in this dimension. People, I want to say something quick. I don't know if it's time. If it's too long, just
say be quiet.
Do you know? Did you know? No, I'm a Muslim, sir. Did you know that a born again person is no longer human? You look human. You're still in the tent.
Yes?
You're still in this thing.
Yeah.
But a born again is not any longer born out of the first Adam. Which came from the humus. That is why it's human. Human. Humus man. Or Adam comes from Adama, which means soil. A born again comes from a life-giving spirit.
Yes.
From heaven.
Yeah.
The Bible says all things have passed away. Look,
yes.
It's all become new.
Amen.
A born again is not human. It's a fact. I'll give you a split. It's the truth. It's the truth. We are still in this form, but we belong to another family.
Yeah.
You know that all these people that go on about family, but you know what? People are going on so much about earthly families. And I'm not saying not important. I'm saying we are forgetting we are part of an eternal, heavenly family. They say that we cannot produce. That's why we are in sin. Bull dust. Yes, dust. We can produce thousands of kids for Jesus. Doesn't take much for you to be an earthly dad. Come with seconds. Let's not go there. And whatever you loose on earth, whatever you loose on earth, loose, do not be loosing. Loose on earth. In other words, declare legal, declare lawful, must be what is already loose in heaven. Lord, I take complete dominion over the atmosphere, the spiritual atmosphere in and around this place, this conference place, right now, in the name of the mighty risen Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you that you have dominion here, Lord, and you alone. Any other spirits in the square, you will bow. In Jesus' name. Matthew 18:19-20. Jesus says, Matthew 18, verse 19 to 20, again I tell you, if two of you on earth agree, harmonize together make a symphony about anything and everything, whatever they shall ask, it will come to pass. Man, is this a free pass or what?
Amen.
And the Almighty God says, listen, if two or three of you can come into complete harmony, complete harmony and unity, you can ask anything to be done for you.
Yes.
Do you know how long division has kept us back?
Yes.
Possibly that knee is broken. I love this man to bits. I love this church to bits. I sent you a text to Ricky Drift, and I said, Pastor Louis, can we not unite and do an outreach? Amen. Yes. Thank you, man. And get some souls. Man and Hazel, man, never. There's unity in the house, people.
Yes.
It took some time. The devil fought it.
Yeah.
But I'm telling you, the dragon has been slain. Yes. Whatever they shall ask, it shall come to pass and be done for them by my heavenly parent in heaven. For wherever two or three are gathered in my name, drawn together as my followers in and into my name,
yes,
there I am in the midst of them. Into my name. Into my name.
Yes.
Tell me something. Are we the body of what?
Christ.
Of Christ. You can't have a body without a head.
Yes.
Or a head without a body.
Mm.
Are we one?
Yes.
Can you imagine? Christ, the risen Lord, and we are one.
Yeah.
You know that the word says that God looks at us with jealous love.
Yeah.
Amen. I had to work through that this year.
Mm.
I've been doing this for many years. This year, even this last couple of weeks, Pastor Debbie, I mean, you and I speak it. I was in tears at my home. And this is going to sound doffy. I said,
yeah.
I said, Father, you love me. And you think, well, you've been doing this for a few years, you should know. I didn't know. I thought I did. Because when we get rejected time after time, even though your intentions are pure, we're not perfect, yes. Not yet. We are perfected legally, not yet practically. Then you begin to look at yourself and you think, well, I deserve it, baby. Acts like me, too stupid. God is me, ministerant, whatever. Is there anybody that knows what I'm talking about?
Yes.
We always say, Jesus loves me. Yes, I know. But do we know? Do we know? And I actually had to kind of get that, like now, just past week, I would say, Father, that's what I said, Father, Papa, you stay for me, all my fault. Men to look for my they have no regard. Don't even talk about the anointed. Leave that one side. Kom ons vergeet nou maar the mantle. Kom ons net aan die hierdie ou.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, that's it.
Let someone withdraw our tithes.
Yeah.
And who must suffer? La deep. Kom ons kyk hoe sy debit orders af. People treat their dogs better.
I don't want to get all heavy. But it's in times like that when you have to go to God, your parent. And do you know what? You never failed me.
Yes.
I'm going to... People turn on God because people hurt them.
Yeah.
What did God do to you?
Yeah.
That is one grace I can thankfully say thank you, God. When people have hurt me, I'm going to turn on Him or on God. I never have. Pastor Deb said, "Thing would come out of my mouth. This is not even near a list. Near. It's just coming out. There are people here, and I think Pastor Louis also said it's coming from it. There are people here that really don't know if God loves you. You've been so indoctrinated by the whole G-A-Y thing.
Yeah.
That you kind of say it, but you don't really believe it. You haven't put on the robes of the King yet. You haven't looked at yourself in the mirror of God's Word through revelation and seeing yourself stand there, not arrogant, but with your head up as royalty. My brother, my oldest brother, the Lord Jesus is my brother. the star-breathing God is my parent. I'm not alone. How many of you have ever felt alone? I mean, I'm really alone. Alone. But you know what? I lock my door in my flat and I go and I speak to my heavenly parent. And I say, Daddy, I'm not alone.
Yes.
I will never be alone.
Yes.
Look at all my brothers and sisters here. And all those that are cheering us on in heaven say, come on.
Yes.
You can do it.
Yes.
Come on. You can do it. The Lord is raising and planting up flags around us tonight as a sign and a testimony. Borders.
Yeah.
Around us. We are marked. Someone said this we get marked.
Tagged.
Or tagged. Boundaries. Take it tonight. There are boundaries being set against the spirit of poverty.
Yes.
Against the spirit of lack.
Yes.
Infirmity. Concerning the harvest. We are our souls, people. When I speak of a church of 100, I find it totally ridiculous. I do. Because that's not a church. It's a hoax. We see all these churches with the thousands. So what? The same spirit that lives in me lives in your lateral Maldonado. And I love the guy. I'm just saying, the same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead lives in me.
Yeah.
Back in him. My heavenly parent wants me also to move in the power of this Holy Spirit. And you too. And wants the thousands and thousands of souls. Because God shall not be mocked.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Philippians 2, 9, 11. Therefore, because he, Jesus, stooped so low, God has it highly exalted him and has freely bestowed on him the name that is above every name, that in that name of Jesus, every knee should and must bow in heaven, the heavenly realm here tonight, where demons and angels move.
Yeah.
But knees will bow.
Yes.
And it will be devils who bow.
Yes.
Then come. Say to you,
confesses and acknowledges that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father, we have the power. I'm going to finish quickly. 1 John 3:8b. Get ready to petition tonight.
Yes.
I'm telling you, God has set this thing up. It's going to snowball into tomorrow morning.
Amen.
1 John 3:8b. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Amen. 1 John 5, verse 4 to 5. For whatever or whoever is born of God, that's you, overcomes the world, the Antichrist system. And this is the victory that has overcome the world. What? Our faith. As you've all been taught, I'm sure, faith is our legal access into the supernatural realm.
Amen. Yeah.
It's legal. We can do it.
Yeah.
We can do it. Amen.
Amen.
2 Corinthians 10. And then we're going to do something. Amen. Verses 3 to 5. I'm setting the stage for war. That's what I'm going to do.
Amen.
Not by me. For though we walk in the flesh, looking like humans. Amen.
Yes.
We do not war according to the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare, the blood-washed, redeemed warfare, are not carnal, meaning it's not human. Okay? So we have weapons and they're not human. But they are mighty in God for pulling down strongholds. Pulling down strongholds. Or an area, whatever. Can the truth not also do it?
Yes.
And better.
Yeah.
More powerful. Stronger. So if spikes can loose all these hojas, can we not release and loose the truth and speak it out and release it into the atmosphere?
Yes.
Can we not trust God's mighty angels to strike down the forces of darkness, to send them packing, amen, in your life, and collectively, this God, God of light. If God is not God, let's all go to the freaking, to the blessed beach. I'm sorry, I am in a mood tonight. I'm up to here. Reading in this precious living pages what I am and what is legally mine. Yet every month, just a gesukkel and a gechunk and a gekerm. Markham's is my smallest account. It's 120 rand a month. Somebody pray for the South African economy. My God, 120 bucks. And I make an EFT on the first of the month. That same evening. Your account is in arrears. Now, if I can swim in. Pastor Louis spoke this morning. Help me. If I know who sent this SMS, this phone, and this text message, is going when the sun don't shine. We saw you on Thursday. We had a blowout time, amen?
Amen. Yeah.
front. Okay.
What's new?
And we actually saw high things coming down.
Yes.
Strongholds coming down. Let your kingdom, the way that it exists in heaven, be made manifest in earth dimension.
Yeah.
Who's going to do it? Christ will lead the charge, but who's going to be there? We are.
Yeah.
We are. Especially the remnant church, amen?
Yeah.
Casting down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. Bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. So do we have that power? Yes, we have that power. Can we do it tonight? Yes. Are we more than two or three? Yes. Do we have authority tonight?
Yes.
We have the Lord Christ Jesus, Yeshua himself, risen upon us.
Yes.
Christ.
Yes.
And the great King, Lord over us. Is the Spirit hearing everything we are saying tonight? Yes, you know why? Because the Spirit is producing it.
Yes.
You say, can the Holy Spirit get so aggro? Yes.
Yes.
Can't you see it? Psalm 68 verse 1 says, let God arise.
Yes.
Let his enemies be scattered.
Yes.
And let those who hate him flee before him. And then as I read earlier, God has gone up with a shout. The Lord with the sound of the trumpet.
Yes.
I'm going to do something quicker and then I'm going to ask apostle and prophet to come and stand with me, please. Because we are going to decree over you. First of all, I've mentioned already, unity. Psalms 133:1. How pleasant it is when brothers and sisters dwell in unity. Amen.
Amen.
And then, can we quickly stand? I want to declare something. I want to ask you to say it with me. Please. First of all, I want us as a collective to ask for, pray for, forgiveness towards the so-called straight churches.
Yeah.
If we want to move in authority, we've got to do things right.
Amen.
Some of you have been hurt by the so-called, I just call it, I don't know what else to call it, mainstream or whatever, churches. And rejected.
Yes.
My pastor thought I was completely whacked. He was trying to, he was sitting next to me with his hand on my back and he was doing this. Well, have fun, honey. Express forgiveness towards, because guys, there's not two, there's only one church. And no matter if they've hurt us, we need to forgive.
Amen.
So can you say this with me? Almighty God,
Almighty God,
tonight by your mercy,
tonight by your mercy,
and your grace,
and your grace,
we speak forgiveness.
We speak forgiveness.
Lord,
Lord,
to what we shall call the straight churches.
To what we shall call the straight churches.
Lord, we forgive them.
Lord, we forgive them.
For what they have uttered.
What they have said. What they have said.
Towards us and against us.
Towards us and against us.
And even where they have rejected our people.
And even where they have rejected our people.
Tonight we say, Lord, on behalf.
Tonight we say, Lord, on behalf.
We forgive them.
We forgive them.
Because God, they don't know better.
Because God, they don't know better.
So by your mercy, Lord.
By your mercy, Lord.
Forgiveness.
Forgiveness.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Now, we want to declare Jesus Christ as the Lord and Master of the human people.
Yeah.
We want to get that established in the heavenlies. Amen.
Amen.
Can you say this with me? Almighty God.
Almighty God. I want you to come and stand in front, because we are going to decree and declare over you. I want, just listen to what I'm saying. I want only the ones that are really, really struggling. We're going to pray for everybody. I asked you in the beginning, is there faith in the house? Yes.
Do we have the authority?
Yes.
Can we do it?
Yes.
I'm going to ask that apostle just decrees over them a release. A supernatural release financially. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus, Jesus. Agree, amen. I feel like, Prophet Jacques, we need to just lead this in with a battle cry, a song. We're an army. I just feel like we need to lead it in with that. So I want you to just, let's intercede, even those of you that are standing up here. And then we're going to pray in a moment, but just begin to claim that which is yours financially, that which is being sown. There are even people, let me just say this, there are even people that earn a very good salary, yet you always find yourself broke.
Yes.
Now let me tell you what, there are two reasons for that. One, because you don't spend your money wisely, and the other is because there's a curse over your finances. So your pocket has always got a hole in it. So you deal with the 10%, you say, Lord, I give you the 10%, why am I always broke? You have to still be a good steward over the 90. That's why. So there is,
amen,
there is a spiritual law, if I can say that, that we have to obey the Lord. But for the rest of us, you've been standing as a Christian and you're waiting on God, and it's time for us to move into being serious about the things of God.
Amen.
Friends, if you're standing up here and you do not tithe, I want to tell you right now that you need to be broken loose from that nonsense that you only give 5 cents and 10 cents to your church. The Bible is clear. In the New Testament, we are to sow.
Yeah.
We're going to take up an offering just now. I know that somebody will remind me about it. Amen. I always forget about the upcoming offering. I always forget about it. Do some declarations.
Yes.
See the sound, there's a new sound being released.
Yes.
There's a new sound that's coming forth, so let's do that. from me, taking what belongs to me. So lift your hands up and decree this with me and say it after me. Lord, I thank you,
Lord, I thank you
that I am an inheritor. Tell you that I think the Lord has instructed me now, so 15% of what I earn every month. So I don't talk about it, I do it. Now that's besides whatever else God wants me to give. Whether I think I can afford it or not, I'd rather be obedient to God and do what God calls me to do, is I understand the principle of the return. Now, when I went to East London the week before last, you know, people get so sick of hearing about seed and hearing about money in church, but you know what, we talk about it outside of church all the time. Because I always say to people, then why we get so hung up when we talk about it in church?
Yeah.
You know, people can ask you for money outside church and, oh, please help this and please help that. But when we talk about money in church and sowing, people freak out.
I don't know why.
And I feel sorry. I feel sorry because you need to understand that you actually do yourself a disservice. You cannot come and stand up here but you don't sow. You cannot come and stand up here and you don't tithe. My friend, you have to listen to me. I've been in ministry for 22 years. And I've been in full-time ministry for 5 years. It hasn't been easy, but God has always had my back.
Okay.
Because I'm a giver. And I love giving. And I've told the Lord, the more the Lord can give me, the more I can give out. The more I can help other churches, the more we can help other people, the more we can build the kingdom together.
Yeah.
You know, in the old age homes and all the other things that we won't be in for very long when, you know, when Christ comes. But anyway, whatever your theology on that, it doesn't matter. Here's the point. So we were asked to sow. Now, in most charismatic churches that believe in prosperity, there's always an offering message because the idea is that there is a teaching about this, right?
Yeah.
And so Apostle Mel Delano was busy giving the teaching and talking about sowing and talking about... All of a sudden, he got such an anointing came on him and he started to talk about sowing. They need to rebuild the roof. It's a huge place. It's a long story, but it's a testimony. But at the end of the day, they need to build a roof and it's going to cost them something like 28 million just to build their roof. Now, I'm not sowing to their ministry because I'm called to like sow into that ministry. I sowed everything I had. And I couldn't really afford it, to be honest, but I couldn't afford not to.
Yes.
I sowed everything I had and it was hard. Let me tell you something. I believe in the principle of giving, but I've given so much already. And I said, but Lord, I've given so much. You know, every night the offering comes and I've been giving, I've been sowing, I've been... And I'm thinking, Lord, but I've given. And the Lord said, give. Give it. Give everything you've got in your purse, everything. And I just took it. And I was like, Lord. And Apostle Mel Donato said to us, the seed that you use here to sow and bless them, for them to get a new roof because it's leaking all over, it was a warehouse that they bought years and years ago. If you sow the seed tonight, within 48 hours, you will see a multiplication return on your money. Ask God what it is. Right now there was an anointing that was released. Right now there was an anointing, he said, that if you sow right now, not tomorrow, not the next day, there is a multiplication anointing that you must ask God whatever it is that you desire. Obviously God always lines that up with the heart of God. Whatever it is you desire, and it shall be yours. It shall be yours. It shall come. And the finance, the provision, will come. And I prayed and I said, Lord, you know we've got this big conference. And I just said, Lord, I know that you, because that's what we sow. We sow this conference. And we just want to recoup, that's all. We just want to come out with whatever God wants us to sow. That I'm sharing this with you because you must understand these are realities. This is where we live in. But we serve a big God,
yes.
The God of the impossible. And we just said, Lord, you know, I just said, Lord, we need provision for this conference in advance because we didn't have money in the bank the way we used to. Hallelujah. Only because we have, all our money is tied up now in this building. Hallelujah. And that's also God. We still have enough every month to pay the rent. And our rent is more than tripled. Well, it's more than 7 times even. And why I'm saying that to you is because God is so good. Within 48 hours, and the people that sowed the seed don't even know what my prayer was. They don't even understand what I was doing in East London, what my prayer was when I gave the offering. Within 48 hours, I had somebody come to me in our congregation who had just managed, they had just got some money in. And they're also giving people, but they just got some money in and they said, Pastor, I just want to tell you that the Lord has shown me to sow the seed. And it covered our conference costs. Do you hear what I'm saying? You have to understand what it is to give. Friends, if we as the eunuch churches do not understand the principle of giving, we cannot stand there with our hands out to God and say, I've sown no field, I've put no seed down, oh but God, like a child, just give me, give me, give me. No, you must learn the principle of giving. You must learn what it is to sow. Not just money, yourself, your time, your sacrifice, your commitment to the work of God, and understand that God sees it all and you shall get a return. So tonight when you sow, whatever it is God has laid on your heart, your tithes belong to your church. Your tithes belong to your church, not to this church. Your offerings, hallelujah. Your offerings, what you feel is over and above your tithe that God is calling you to give and to bring into this conference and to sow. When you do it, I want you to ask the Lord, what is the provision that you are looking? What is the need financially that you have? And all of you that came and stood up here asking for provision, if you want, turn around, sow something tonight. Sow something tonight. Hallelujah. And it's up to you. I mean, you know, Jesus spoke more about money in the New Testament than many other things. How many of you have read it? Hey? In fact, when they took the offering, he was the one standing there talking about it. And he checked it. We mustn't be embarrassed about tithing. Pastors, don't be embarrassed to teach about tithing in your churches. Come on, it's the word of God. It brings, we want abundance. We want prosperity. We must learn to understand the principle. It's not always free. It's not always, oh, free, free, free. The church, everything must be free. We must move away. Whatever is free comes from the Spirit, yes, but we must learn to be givers. It's not always take, take, take. And I'm not prepared to sow. I'm not prepared to mature in my faith and understand the principle of giving. Amen?
Yeah.
I want to tell you, whenever somebody comes to me and says, listen, I've got financial difficulties, the first question they will tell you that I ask them is, are you tithing?
Yeah.
Are you sowing into the house of the Lord?
Yeah.
Are you giving? Oh, but you know, Pastor, I can hardly have nothing at the end of the month. Well, that's right. You have nothing at the end of the month. Give it 6 months of consistent tithing. And with the other 90% or whatever it is God has called you to tithe, I want to see you be a good steward. If you do those two things, if you do not get prosperous financially or overcome this hurdle, I'll give you the money that you sown and tithe back. I think that's a good deal.
Yeah.
I haven't had one person come back to me yet. I haven't had one. And I'm telling you now, I know. It's not that everybody in our church tithes. Many might not, but the point is that when they start, they will find the prosperity of the word coming to pass in their lives. Friends, it's not just a thing that churches do. If you've had a curse over your life because your churches have taken from you, or you've been done in by somebody financially, or even a church, or even a Christian, you need to have that curse broken off you, because it's stopping you from inheriting your prosperity and your inheritance financially. Not just all the other inheritances we're talking about on earth as it is in heaven, but even financially.
Yeah.
It's a curse on you. It's a curse on you. And every time, if you are freaked out, every time somebody speaks about money in the church, it's a curse on you. You need to have that broken and you need healing from it.
Yes.
And make sure before you leave this conference that you get that.
Yeah.
And it's not a gambling thing, oh Lord, if I sow, you know, $1,000, oh gosh, you know, hey, the Lord's going to give me 10, you know. It's not that. It's a principle of giving.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
We don't just give once. It's in our hearts. That's why the, yes.
Thank you, Lord.
So thank you, Lord, for your word. And thank you that you are sowing truth into our hearts. Thank you, Lord, that we understand that as we give, we do receive. Freely we give. Freely we receive. And so freely we give tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. For everyone that has sown, just as the widow had two coins, and the Lord said that she would be prosperous and not the rich person, even though he gave more in rands, so to speak, it was the widow that the Lord saw. It was because her heart, she gave everything she had. So the Lord sees your hearts tonight, so just lift your hands up like this. And just make a decree over the offering you have given to the Lord, because the measure that you give, amen, is how you will receive your multiplication.
Thank you.
You want to start exercising your faith.
Yeah.
You want to start exercising your faith. You want to be promoted. You want to move into the deep things of God. Exercise.
Yes.
You know why tithing is so important? Because it's the very starting block of learning to give to Him in faith and trusting God with your money and not thinking that you know better than God what to do with your finances. Work on a biblical principle, not your own opinion, and you will prosper. So right now we just decree together, Lord, that as we have sown, just repeat it after me. We decree. As we have sown. And as we have heard the word.
Regarding sowing.
And reaping.
We take our inheritance.
And even for some of you, this is the start of your sowing. Some of you haven't even sown before the Lord's just shown me. There's some of you that this is the very first time or first time in a long time that you've even sown, or that somehow the word is, you've heard the word. But the Lord says that this is the start for you. Do not stop and increase as you go. Increase it as you go. Increase it as you go. Friends, if we want our churches to become something, we have to sow into the houses to which we belong. Not just once. Oh Lord, I've given so much, so therefore I don't have to give you. Oh, you know, can I tell you something? Everything you have belongs to God.
Yeah.
You don't have it because of yourself. You have it because God's mercy is upon your life.
Yeah.
Okay? In the Old Testament, they gave, it had to be an animal that was unblemished.
Yeah.
And what happened to those that wanted to provide animals that were blemished? And when we don't give of our offering, we're giving God blemished stuff. It's not the Old Testament, but it's the same principle.
Yes.
I'm not saying because I don't even have enough money.
Yeah.
Well, that's when I need to sow.
Yeah.
The first thing I do every month is sow my seed and also pay my tithe. That's the first thing I do. And sometimes I pay the tithe that God has given me, or 15%, or whatever God tells me I need to give. And then I still have to give an offering over and above that because God tells me to do it. Whether I think I have enough or not. I'm responsible with my bills, I'm just saying. The first thing I need to do, I am fearful of the Lord in the reverence of God. I want to do what honors God.
Amen.
And your offering is an honoring of God.
Amen.
Just as the lamb without blemish. And so we speak, just say, we speak.
We speak.
We speak prosperity,
prosperity.
And blessing.
And
the breaking of every curse. And we push back the dominion of darkness. In the area of our finances. And tonight we declare. Our finances are released. In Jesus' name. By the Spirit. If you need any ministry in the Spirit, we have some pastors, plenty of pastors. Pastors, just come and stand up here for me, with me. But come and stand right here as you feel led, and you need ministry and anybody to minister to you in the Spirit, and the pastors will minister to you, and then we can make our way through.